This is Derek Hegsted. I'm the visual arts director over my school. Today, we're working on graphite. These are my tools of choice. Sometimes you can use pencils. This is a tool that I love. It's a mechanical or a architectural pencil. It has a sharpener on the end that you can be able to sharpen your pencil, or you can be able to use something that I was given to by Kum, K-U-M, and it's a sharpener that they donated to my class, one of the best tools ever. It has little holes here on the side where it can be able to sharpen. The next tool that I use is your kneaded eraser. You want this to be able to soften edges, take up mistakes, stuff like that. You create the tongue of the dog, and it just barely touches. You'll see me work that. We're going to start on this. On your background, you want to have this type of texture. The texture helps the ball even look more smooth. And we're working at this as an exercise towards moving towards skin tones. You can use all sorts of different backgrounds, crosshatch, circular motions. I call them chicken feet, whatever. Just keep it rough so that it'll make the skin tone or the ball tone look even more smooth. When you start, you can see little scratches here. You can see how smooth these are here. But what we want to do is we want to be able to start this. And this pencil needs to be a little bit more dull. If it's too sharp, it'll cause gouges. So sometimes I will do this and I'll round it off so it's not so sharp. See how rounded off it is? Okay, and we come back through and we test it. Now, with our kneaded eraser, I'm gonna put some gouges in, and I wanna show you what happens. Oh, look, darn, that's too dark. I know. Then you just take this right here, and you just barely kiss it. Just like that. You have to make the sound effects, okay? And then gently. Now, one of the things that's important is that you want to make sure that your plastic is available to not smudge. You do not want to smudge graphite. What that does is that takes away the credibility of your graphite. Charcoal, you can be able to smudge, but graphite, please don't. The joy and the magic of graphite is to make it look as if it's been sprayed on. So when we do this, we just gently, gently put this together. And you're doing little small circles. You're barely touching it. This shows your ability to control. And you go in between. Don't keep crossing over lines. Don't do cross hatches here. Now you notice that I'm just barely touching it. But see how smooth it is still? But look at the lines. Look at the lines. Okay? Now what you want to do is to be able to make it even more smooth. Then you go ahead and you sharpen this. Make it sharp. And then you come back through and you go little. See the little white lines? See the little white dots? You go in between little small portions. You jump. And if you have anything dark like this right there, you go back through, pinch this, and then just barely touch. Come back through and touch it again. thing is to be patient. Make it as smooth as possible. This is an exercise in controlling a medium. It's not about making it perfect. It's about how do we learn how to control a medium so that later on we can be able to do stuff like this. This is a piece that I did in college. All in graphite, all with the shadows. There's no smudging. So to conclude, we want to be able to have the right materials, have the right example in front of you, and understand what makes things look real. Happy drawing.